guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you're all having an awesome day. So in today's video, we're going to be talking about the very best and the very worst concealers out there. I did a recent video like this on the, you know, my top favorite and most hated eyeshadow palettes. If you want to see that, I will link it down below and on the screen. And so many of you were requesting for me to do that for, you know, like other product categories. So I thought, why not do it with concealers? I have included both high-end and drugstore options in both categories. So yeah, if you want to see the very best and worst concealers, then please keep on watching. So first up, I have to mention the MAC Pro Longwear Concealer. This is the concealer that I have loved for the longest amount of time. I discovered this concealer when I was first learning to be a makeup artist, and I just thought it was the bee's knees. It is super lightweight and actually quite liquidy. It comes with a little pump applicator. Whoa, and mine is filthy. But what I really love about it is even though it's so thin in consistency, it is so full coverage. I love that it doesn't crease, it doesn't cake, it will cover up all of your worst sins. Just a really awesome concealer. Now, one con that I do have is actually glass packaging, so don't go throwing it at a wall. It'll smash. Next up, I've got a more recent love, the Tarte Shape Tape. Now, let me tell you the hype that is going on about this product at the minute. It's totally legit. Like, it's not one of those hyped products that when you actually get it and try it out, you're like, ugh, what are these girls thinking? Like, this stuff is ridiculous. It is so full coverage. It is so creamy. It doesn't crease. Color range is beautiful. Finish is beautiful. Texture is beautiful. The entire thing is beautiful. It does come with a doe foot applicator, and the applicator is actually massive. I find that if I go in and apply this with the applicator, I end up using way too much. So I usually will pop it on the back of my hand and use a brush to apply it. But I promise you, under the eyes, on blemishes, on redness, it will not let you down. Next up, I've got the Estee Lauder Double Wear Waterproof Concealer. Now, I absolutely love Estee Lauder Double Wear. You all know that. This is not news. Being an oily skin type, I need products that don't muck around. Like, I don't want to put my makeup on and then have it melting all over my boobs in an hour. This stuff is budge-proof. The only thing with this one is I probably wouldn't recommend it for underneath the eye areas. This one is more for redness, rosacea, acne, breakouts, discoloration, hyperpigmentation, all of that. Just don't use it under the eyes because it will crease. And this stuff is also like paint, and you're going to need some waterproof makeup remover to get it off. Next up, I got a couple of loves from NARS. So I've got the NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer, and this new one, this is their Soft Matte Complete Concealer. I used to think that this was the best NARS concealer, but now that this one's arrived, I can't decide. These are both really, really full coverage, really creamy, easy to blend, easy to wear. I don't find that they cake. They've got really good brightening benefits. They both look fantastic under the eyes and anywhere else on the face. I honestly can't choose between them. NARS does beautiful products. We all know that. And if I was a millionaire, I would buy them all. I would say that this one's got more coverage than this one. This one is a cream-based concealer with a matte finish. And I would say that it's a little higher in coverage, whereas this one's got more of a brightening effect. It just depends on what you're after. But I couldn't choose between them. I use them both, so it had to be in here. Moving on to drugstore, the Maybelline Fit Me Concealer has been a ride or die drugstore product for me for years. I absolutely love the consistency of these. The packaging's beautiful. The texture is beautiful of the formula. It's a tiny, weeny little baby doe foot applicator, so I can use it on the inner corners of my eyes or areas that are hard to reach. Beautiful colors, beautiful blendability. It's such a gorgeous concealer, and in my opinion, I actually think that it's an exact dupe for the NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer. So if you're not wanting to splurge on this one, definitely try this one out. You can pick this one up, I think, for about $5, and it is so nice. Another one by Maybelline. This is their Master Conceal by Face Studio. They call this their Camouflaging Concealer, and they are not lying. I remember when I was first introduced to the product, and I opened it up, and I put it on the back of my hand, and I was like, oh no, I'm not going to be able to wear this as an oily skin type because it is quite emollient. It's very thick, very creamy. And I was like, oh, I can just see this melting down my face. I promise you, this stuff will set down and it will not budge. It is so beautiful. Take care under the eyes. Don't apply, you know, huge amounts because it will settle into fine lines. But if you go in with a little brush, you'll be fine. And the only other con is I don't think that it comes in that many colors. So I personally have to mix two shades to make my perfect match because they don't actually have my correct shade. Next up, I've got the Wake Me Up Concealer by Rimmel. Now, this is my go-to everyday natural radiant sort of concealer. I can chuck this on without wearing any other makeup and really blend out the edges, and it just looks like I've had a good night's sleep. You know, I won't reach for this when I'm looking for something, you know, super high coverage with like a really dramatic makeup look. This is sort of my everyday go-to, really radiant, really natural looking. It doesn't crease. You pretty well can't see it on the skin. It just looks like those under eye bags were never there. If only If only they weren't there in the first place. I personally cannot drink coffee. I don't do well with caffeine. Like, I'm excited most of the time. You should see me on caffeine. It is terrifying. So this is like my caffeine in a bottle when I need to look a little bit more awake. And then lastly, I've got this one by Essence, and I was so surprised by this because I think this cost me like $1. This is their Stay All Day 16-Hour Long Lasting Concealer. Is that what it's called? Yes, it is. You guys, this stuff is such good quality. I just can't understand how it is so affordable. Like, how? How is that only a couple of dollars? Like, what? It really does last a long time. I don't find that it creases, and it's actually super high coverage. So yeah, for those of you looking for something super affordable and super long wearing, I would check this one out. Okay, moving on to the concealers that I don't like. Hard Candy Glamouflage Heavy Duty Concealer. Now, I don't like this because it separates. It separates into pigment and oil. I pull it out of the drawer and I hope that you're going to be able to see this, but look, just oil comes out. You can see it running down my hand. That's not concealer, that's oil. It's literally like just clear oil. It's probably actually nice and hydrating in the back of my hand. And obviously I'm not completely stupid, you know, I try to mix it, you know, I really try and get that product to mix back together. I can't, it stays separated. So Hard Candy, I don't like you. Next up, I got the Makeup Forever Ultra HD Invisible Cover Concealer. I think this will be better if it was named Invisible Concealer because it just, you cannot see it on the skin. There is absolutely no coverage. I've just applied that on the back of my hand there, and like you can see my skin through it. Oh, I don't know. I get that it's HD makeup and the idea of it is to not show up in HD like camera situations, but my dark under eyes show up on camera still, even when I'm wearing this, and that's not what I'm looking for. Next, I've got the Maybelline Super Stay 24 Hour Concealer. I tried so hard to love this. I really did. It definitely stays on for 24 hours. No kidding. The only thing is it's super cakey. Like, it doesn't feel like a particularly heavy formula when you apply it, but for some reason it settles into every single pore, every fine line, and it just gets cakey. So doesn't make the cut. Another concealer I've had absolutely no luck with is the IT Cosmetics Bye Bye Under Eye. This is their full coverage anti-aging waterproof concealer. I really love the concept behind this. You know, this is a concealer that's specifically for under the eye area, for dark under eye circles, you know, pigmentation and all of that. But I don't know what happens. It reacts with my skin somehow, and I've tried it with different primers and foundations and I can't seem to get it to work. But my under eye areas develop a lot of texture and they look crepey, if that makes sense, when I'm wearing this. I know that this product's got a huge cult following. Unfortunately, much like the Thermomix cult that I'm not a part of, don't hate me guys, I just don't get the point spending $2,500 on a kitchen appliance. But yeah, And then lastly, oh, and it does hurt me, I've got the Too Faced Born This Way Concealer. Now, I personally like this when I'm looking for daytime natural wear, not much cover concealer. Like, this one blends out really nicely, much like the Rimmel Wake Me Up. But the thing is, if I'm going to spend this much money on a concealer, I'm going to want it to have a little bit more payoff than that. I do love the formula though. Like, I do. Just for those of you who are, you know, if you really love your concealer, you love to conceal like your soul and everything, you're probably not going to like this one because it's not a high coverage concealer. It's more of like a natural radiant concealer. So I feel like this one doesn't fit into either category, if that makes sense. So that is it for the video today, guys. I hope you found this very helpful. Please let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. Have you tried any of these concealers and what are your thoughts on them? Do you love them? Do you hate them? Please let me know. And also, if you've got any Holy Grail concealers that you think I absolutely need to try, please tell me them. I feel like it's time for some shopping. Some retail therapy. Yep. I love you guys so much and I will catch you all in the next video. Bye!